first of all, thank you for voting for this talk. I'm sure that you were voting this talk because of the title. I hope you like it. Okay, let me first put you in context. So here we have what could be our knowledge. What sits inside the circle is what we know. What sits outside in the blank is simply what we don't know. Okay? Easy. But in reality, this is the real perspective. What we know is very little. But okay, we can live with that. I mean, as long as we are inside our circle, we are typically happy. And the reality is that when we go to the school, we are taught to learn things that already exist. And this means that we simply take the book, go to the internet, we take our smartphone, we go to Wikipedia, and we learn what we are told to learn. And eventually, even in the school or in the university, in our degree, we are told to pass some exams. And they ask about things we already know. And it's good, because we are successful. We are asked about things that we have been studying, and we answer these questions. And it's easy. And we are successful, okay? But the thing is that one day we decide to join the BSC and to do research, especially when you start, when you do the PhD. And then, I mean, the thing is that you arrive here and you think, okay, I've been successful all my life. I've been studying, learning, passing all the exams. They ask me something new. Okay, either I know it, either I learned it. I only need to look for the source for the information and pass the exams. And when you arrive here, you think that reality is something like this. And this is a problem. And this is a problem in the moment that you are made to go outside this circle. And this is research about. Research is basically about this gap. So you arrive here. You arrive in this site. I know everything. I'm used to be really successful. Everything I'm asked to do, I know how to do it. And if I know where to look for the answer. But eventually, you get into research. And your small circle out there is where you stay, and you're pushed outside. You're simply pushed outside. And then you realize that you don't know where to start. You have no guidance. You have no clue, because you've been trained to be successful, to learn things that already exist, and eventually you jump here and you say, okay, now you have to answer this question. You say, okay, let's go to Google. You Google, no answer. You ask your colleagues, no answer. You ask your advisor, and your advisor can tell, okay, you can try this, you can try this other thing. The reality is that your advisor doesn't have the answer either. Nobody has the answer. And this is normally a problem, a shock for new people starting research. And the thing is that you jump outside, let's say, of area of comfort, and then you find yourself stupid. And you find yourself stupid because it's something completely different to what you have been doing in your life. Now, instead of learning what others discovered, you have to discover by yourself. And you don't know how to discover. Eventually, with the help of your advisor, you come up with some ideas, you try something, and you fail. You try another thing, and you fail again. And again, and again, and again, and again. And it's everything about failure. And this is a big jump, because you move from being completely successful to being a systematic failure. And I mean, come on, you are here because you are brilliant. I mean, BSC is not hiring, let's say, dumb people to do research. You are here because you are brilliant. So you are, let's say, used to be systematically successful. And when you jump here, you realize you are not. You are not successful. You are failing all the time. But let me tell you something. I will tell you this because after 20 years in this community doing research, I feel old enough to say these things, but research is about failing. And I would say that the most important part of research is what you learn from failure, not what you learn from success. And in fact, when you fail, you learn two things. First, you know that there's something that is wrong. And come on, tell the other people that this is wrong, so that they don't make the same mistake. And the second thing is that you're training your intuition. So next time, perhaps, who knows, you are lucky, and you find the answer. But it's okay failing. In fact, I would tell you that as an advisor of some students, What I expect my students is to fail. And I know that this generates frustration, because you have spent all your life being successful, and now you are systematically failing. Don't worry. This is what you are here for, to fail. Because we build knowledge upon failure. Yeah, sporadically you get some success, you get some result, you get a paper, but I mean, don't worry. I mean, when your advisor tells you, don't worry, keep doing, you're doing well, trust them, trust your advisors. They know what they are talking about. I know that there may be even some of you that may be thinking on giving up at some point, just thinking, okay, perhaps this is not what I'm here for. I mean, I'm not good enough. Don't worry, if you are here, it's because you are good enough. But you need to learn from failure and find your motivation. And your motivation is the discoveries you will find outside. So you need to be aware that all this blank outside is to be filled, and to be filled by you. And you are the ones that will be finding the wonderful things you have outside, okay? I can tell you, I had plenty of fun preparing this slide. So that was the message I had, mainly for young researchers. Don't be afraid of failing. Don't be afraid of feeling stupid. In fact, you need to learn that feeling stupid is, let's say, the natural state of a researcher. It's a state where you need to feel comfortable and to feel the motivation of finding all these discoveries. So just last slide. I got the inspiration from this talk, from this paper. It's just one page, but it's worth to read. I recommend you. Thank you.